We'll press onwards for now.
Yeah.
I see a bunch of guys up that way.
Liquidy should go drive a little.
There's big guy over there.
That's probably nothing.
Yeah, it's probably not worth worrying about.
Okay, the bell ring woman appeared. Did she not ring the bell, or did she?
She did.
Yeah. She did.
Yeah, it even said sinister timber and all that.
Yeah.
Ah, so what you're saying is netcode is happening right now.
Oh no.
Because I have been sitting with the sinister bell rung for like the last 2 minutes, and it's still telling me that it's searching for the chime of a sinister bell.
The hell?
Well, sometimes it finds it, and sometimes it doesn't find it.
I got somebody.
Thanks, netcode.
I got somebody else earlier, so like it's not that it's not working.
Sinister bell resonates with another.
Ooh.
Yes.
Aha, there we go.
There you are.
It's okay, Argate. I've got your back. All the way over here, I've got your back.
What the? Hello.
Welcome to a game of magic, my friend.
Oh, you are wearing. I like what you're wearing.
Yeah, that's good.
I like what you've got.
I like the cut of your jib, sailor.
You missed there. That one was less of a miss.
Oh, hello, netcode.
Ooh, well, don't want to get caught in the middle of this mess.
As funny as this is, and it is.
All right, camera, please awesome. Get out of the thing.
I
are
see
you cheering
just gesturing
on?
In the background?
Oh.
Wow, okay.
Doink.
But who am I cheering for?
The answer is yes. Oh, that was a nice move.
I'm on TV! Oh, this is getting really close to the stand.
You're like those insane rally fans who stand and almost get run over trying to take pictures.
Oh.
Unfortunately, I'm out of bullets, so I can't use the fun times anymore.
I mean, you could.
Yeah.
You're right, I could.
Ah, the old blood bullet dance.
Oh, hey, ah! There you go, you did it.
I win!
And this is why we don't do invasions, because invasions take fucking forever.
Yeah, Jesus Christ.
Hopefully the next one won't take quite so long.
I think you could call me a fair weather fan.
The bell ringing women rang another bell.
Okay, oh, we well should then, probably yeah. hurry then.
Yeah, you definitely want to mosey.
I wasn't expecting that outcome.
I mean, if we're being honest, I was.
Beware the unseen.
Oh, right. You don't have a fog door here yet.
Oh, that's a boss, isn't it? Yeah, I'm gonna go cash in then.
Oh.
Look, man, 45,000 souls.
It's true. That's a lot of souls.
That's a lot of souls! It's not that many souls.
Yeah, that's like two levels for me.
Oh. Yeah, I guess I gotta disrupt resonance first. Thank you for cheering, Liquidy.
Oh.
It was a good cheer session.
Now would be a good time for one of those homeward bones.
Oh, that was so good.
The reaction was just perfect.
So, fun thing about the tentacle hand, you can stagger people with that.
Really?
Yeah, so like if I had caught you with it when you were starting an attack, you would have gotten knocked over for a visceral.
That's pretty awesome.
In addition to using it to parry, if you sneak up behind somebody and use that, it knocks them into a parry state.
Nice.
So, against NPC enemies, you can actually get behind them and just tentacle shotgun real quick, and...
That's pretty rad. That is not what I wanted.
I appreciate you using my phrasing.
Well, I really like it.
Well, now that we've had our fun with invasions, let's actually finish this area.
Let me just fill my stock of Molotovs again.
Not to be the one to rain on your parade, but how are you on time?
I should have like 15 minutes.
Yeah, here's hoping that's plenty. Yeah,
that's probably good. That's good for at least one shot. This.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can make a nice dead man sprint. Just get over there.
But yeah, I guess we should briefly kind of explain magic items, because that's what I was using. magic in this game specifically takes the form of items. Like, you don't learn spells or anything. You just kind of pick up stuff. And they do cool things, like the tentacle hand. And there's another one that I have that I will demo at some point for you, where it's basically like... You basically get instant rolls and dodges that they kind of become teleports instead.
Oh, yeah, that thing.
That sounds cool.
Yeah. Oh, I don't think I ever got that. I would have used the hell out of that.
But it's not, you say, that particular one's pretty shitty because it only lasts for like 15 seconds. But the idea is there. But you need to have a bunch of arcane for it to actually work. Like, right now, like, you need at least 10 points for even the most basic of spell items. And you need between 15 and 25 for any of the good shit.
Yeah.
Jeez. That's quite the investment.
Yeah, tentacle shotgun is 18. But it's also the most useful one. So, you know, there's that.
It's the besterest.
Well, I have one I think is the best, but we won't be seeing it for quite a bit. then again, I'm more of a fun before function or form, I guess.
Yeah, fun greater than all.
And it's a fun one.
That didn't go nearly as smoothly as you'd hoped, I think.
Now, I wonder if I could just go right past them.
Probably.
Yeah, you probably could.
Yeah, I'm gonna give that a shot. In the meantime, got another story, Liquidy?
Got a long one.
Okay, that'll probably make up for the ones you skipped.
Several years ago, I worked for a quick-service restaurant chain that is known for their seafood. At the time of this incident, I was working the opening shift, which meant that I had to get there early in the morning to do prep and get the restaurant ready for business. Opening crew had to go around to the back of the building, knock on the door, and wait for the manager to let them in. One morning, my sister dropped me off at work as usual. I got out of the car and she drove off. I knew my manager was there because his car was in the parking lot. I walked up to the back door and knocked. I waited about 30 seconds, but no one came to the door, so I knocked a little louder. All of a sudden, I hear someone pounding on the wall next to the door. Bang, bang, bang. I knocked again and called out my manager's name. I heard the pounding again, followed by my manager yelling for help. I started freaking out, not knowing what was wrong and worried that he might be hurt. I had images of him being robbed and tied up or something running through my mind. Yes, I know I have a very overactive imagination. Anyhow, incidentally, there was a fire truck at the restaurant next door, so I pulled out my phone to call my sister and told her what was going on. I asked her to call the police while I ran next door to try to get help. I ran up to their back door and started knocking. The manager came out a moment later and I explained the situation to her. She actually got rather testy with me and said, "I don't have time for this right now, one of my vats exploded." I was a little taken aback and responded with, "Well, my manager is in there yelling for help and I don't know if he's hurt or what. I need to get inside and make sure he's okay." She pretty much blew me off, so I ran back over to the other building just as the cops pulled up. I ran to meet them and told them what was going on. They walked over to the back door and tried knocking. Once again, we heard my manager calling for help. There was no knob or handle on the outside of the door, so one of the cops decided to bust out a window. Before they could, I noticed the fireman who had been next door walking across the parking lot carrying what looked like a huge crowbar. Apparently, the manager there had let them know we needed help. They asked us to stand back, and two of them were able to bust the door open. We all made our way into the building. The walk-in freezer was located right near the back door, so we figured he must be in there. One of the firemen went to open the door, but one of the cops stopped him. "Wait, we don't know who's in there." I'm sitting there thinking, of course we know who it is, it's my boss. Anyway, the cop drew his gun and slowly opened the freezer door. Sure enough, out walked my manager. He was wearing a rain slicker and his glasses were all fogged up. It was a pretty amusing sight. I was relieved that he wasn't hurt. He looked around at everyone and said thanks. Apparently, he had gone in early that morning to try and fix one of the fans in the freezer. He'd closed the door behind him, not realizing that the inside handle was broken, and got trapped. The poor guy was in there for over 2 hours.
That sucks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have they never heard the phrase lockout tagout?
So, yeah, Witch of Hemwick. This is a pretty good boss.
Yeah, even I really enjoyed this boss, if I remember right.
This reminds me of, one of those bosses from Dark Souls 2. I don't remember which one.
Yeah, it beats me.
I don't remember, like, anything about Dark Souls 2, so...
Yeah, me neither.
Oh, we should all grab Scholar of the First Sin and...
Fuck you.
No, thanks.
Even I think that's dumb.
Oh, hi, there's more.
Two of you just had a Mexican standoff. You did not draw fast enough, though.
Nope. All right, witch, where are you? There, that's not the witch, but I will beat this thing up.
I don't know, that looks like a witch to me.
It's not the witch, though.
It might be there a witch. Depends on if it floats.
Does it weigh more than a duck?
I don't know. Well, the witch is dead? Oh, no, it's not. Hello.
That's weird.
That did seem a little easy. What hit me? Oh, it's still alive from down there.
Yeah, so this is the gimmick of the Witch of Hemwick. There's two of them. And they can both summon new dudes and, like, stun you with spells and shit.
Yep.
That's pretty cool, actually.
Yeah, this isn't a particularly hard boss. I actually really enjoy this fight. But then, I say that, and then Liquidy and I spent, like, 4 or 5 attempts on this thing that we really should not have.
That combo's going a little badly.
Oh.
I can't see.
Oh, she's got the ice cream scoop out. Oh, man.
I was not aware camera fuckery was going to be a part of this fight.
Yeah, I was wrong when I said the cleric beast was the only instance. It's pretty much everywhere. I'm sorry for your loss.
That.
Alternate suggestion. The game is trying to simulate you having your eye scooped out with an ice cream scooper.
A good explanation for bad camera.
Maybe you shouldn't get hit by that, maybe.
It would help if, it were on screen. Just a thought.
Well, you're the one who's not looking at the witches.
Yeah, you're looking at the mooks.
Why would you waste your time on the mooks?
Because I couldn't see the witch. That's not the witch either.
Gotta find her. Ooh.
Yeah, I'm looking.
It's like the worst game of hide and seek.
I mean, for what it's worth, there's only two of them, so you are almost there.
Will they continue to revive each other?
Maybe.
I've never let it get that far.
Unsure.
I mean, we could find out.
Well,
that sounded good.
Oh, you're getting the scoop.
That didn't really do all that much damage.
Only half your health.
Although that might have been the catalyst for reviving the witch.
Oh my.
Very well could have been.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
She got one hit point, right?
Oh.
Hey, there you go. Now just don't die before the animation finishes.
Got it. Don't worry.
No, there you go. Look at you with your first try on the witches.
That was cool, if a little annoying for the camera and that last bit there.
So instead of going back home,
out of a From game,
just go ahead and go to the back hallway there. Trust me, don't go back. Okay. Just saving you some time.
Ooh. And that's the thing I came here to get?
That's what you're here for.
That's the one. Alright, nice. Now let's head back to the Hunter's Dream.
Alright. Not sure I have enough souls for a level, but we'll see.
You're about the same level I am, I need like 15,000, 16,000, so you're pretty close.
Yeah, if nothing else, I'll just pop a couple of cold dews. Oh no, I don't need any. That's perfect.
Oh yeah, look at that.
Oh, look at Mr. Fancy Pants able to level up over here.
Okay, so how do I do the rune? Oh, wait, no, it's this thing over here, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yep.
Okay.
So, runes are basically just little passive buffs that you get.
Yeah.
So, like, the one lets you hold an extra blood vial, and there's one that makes you take less damage, and, you know, you just kind of mix and match whichever ones you want.
Well, I don't feel like using the beast one, so we're going to go with these three.
Well, since you don't really have much choice otherwise.
I mean, I could go without, but who would do that?
No one we know would do that.
Oh, that's just one extra blood vial.
Yeah.
Well, hey,
okay.
Every little bit helps. Don't knock it.
I suppose.
And for what it's worth, you will be getting better runes later on. So, like, you'll get one that lets you carry 3 more blood vials or 5 more blood vials, and yeah. it gets better.
Okay.
Oh, I forgot about the rope Molotov.
Can't really think of a situation where I'd want to use one, but
you spend a
I'm
lot
sure.
of time running away.
Yeah, but if I'm running away, I don't want to fight.
Bravely usually. Running away.
All right, well, that was fun.
Yeah, this one worked out.
All right, so yeah, I guess next time we do Amelia and then plot.
Plot will happen.
Plot.
Plot, you say?
Well, plot's what we fall back on when the jokes run thin.
What have we been doing all session? Oh no.
All right. Well, see you guys next time.
Good
night. See you
later.